Hello my dear viewers, welcome to my channel. Today I am here to cook chicken curry, and let's have a fast look at the ingredients which I kept ready for you to see. Fourth cup of curds. This is homemade curds. Now when I say homemade curds, I have taken out from here. Next video I can teach you how to make good homemade curds. Is 3/4 cup, 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste which I made it at home, 2 sliced onions, coriander for garnish, 1 small sized tomato, a few curry leaves, salt, this is dry coriander powder made at home, red chili powder bought from the market, garam masala, and I have cumin seed powder also, I will get it, and pepper powder. And of course, to prepare meats, I always put in some ghee. I will start the preparation. It's the seasoning first. And you watch step by step how I use the dry masalas and the wet masala. Okay. I put coconut oil, 2 tablespoons of ghee, let it get heated, put in curry leaves, put in the onion. Saute the onions till they become brown. I'll put in little salt so the onions get fried easily. Properly, okay? Not hurry. Every ingredient has got its own temperature and time of frying and cooking. I always like to use curry leaves. Some may not like it, you can avoid that. That ginger garlic paste and this ginger garlic paste, and this has to be sauteed well. You can increase the flame depending upon, don't allow it to burn, that's all. I'll use little more ghee. Now put in the tomatoes. Just keep on stirring it, at least it gets burnt down. Decrease the flame. Once the tomatoes become soft, put in the chicken, and the chicken I have washed in many waters. Drain the water. Okay, that I don't have to tell you. Cleanliness is so important. And keep frying this like this. pieces lose a little color, okay? From raw color, it will become a little whitish in color. Keep trying. You can increase the flame. Now is the time to put in the dry masala. Okay, this masala teaspoon, 1.5 of coriander powder. 1 teaspoon of cumin seed powder. 3/4 spoon of turmeric powder. 1 spoon of pepper. And little more salt. After this, put in chili powder. Depends upon how much you want. So I like it medium pungent. This masala. 2, 3, 4, 5. Stir it properly. You can increase, decrease the flame, okay? Don't allow it to burn. Of course, this vessel doesn't allow the dish to get burnt. Put in some water for it to cook. Now, this is the time I will put in the garam masala. This is. Don't put it in the beginning. Now, I will put in this paste which I have made. In advance, I make and keep it in the deep freeze. It is 3 tablespoons of this. This is dry coconut roasted and onion paste. So it is coconut onion paste in equal measures. Okay, this gives the gravy the little more consistency because people would like to eat it with steamed rice or whatever, roti, whatever it is. Can add in a little water. I have to add curds later on. I will do that. Let this get cooked with the coconut onion paste. Don't reduce the flame. Let it get cooked. It's a homemade curd, it's not very sour. It's a fresh curd. Let it cook for 10 minutes. To see if it is cooked, the pieces. No, it has to be cooked. It has to be cooked. So it is done. I have to check for the salt. It's done. Just garnish it with. I always like, you can put or you don't garnish it with that. This is an optional. And put it off. Salt and pungency depends upon how you like it. You can have a steamed rice, roti, chapati, whatever you like. You know what is beautiful about it? It is hot vessel and I can still lift it. Burgeoners. My dear viewers, enjoy preparing the chicken curry, okay? And click on the bell icon. Please put in your comments and enjoy cooking and healthy life. Thank you.